Let's compare the resonance-based valence bond explanation of delocalized electrons to the molecular orbital theory explanation. And so we've seen before that with neutral resonance, we go all the way to the end, as many arrows as it takes for a diene or polyene, and we generate one contributor. And we don't really like this because it separates charge in an otherwise neutral and nonpolar compound. And then if we go the other way to get the final contributor, we end up with this structure. With charges on the opposite end. And so we said then that if we combine these three contributors together, we end up with our resonance hybrid with a partial bond at every position on the diene. With the molecular orbital theory approach, however, we can explain pi delocalization without invoking these ridiculous charge-separated resonance contributors. So if we look at four atomic orbitals, four p orbitals, when we put four atomic orbitals in to molecular orbitals, we must get four molecular orbitals out. And the lowest energy orbital of any compound is always where everything is in phase. And so if we look at the p orbitals here, we'll color green for a positive phase and leave the negative phase of the orbitals white. The lowest energy orbital would be where everything's in phase. A node at the nucleus, because p orbitals have a node at the nucleus. But otherwise, everything is in phase. Okay? And what if, to get the next, we put a nodal line in? So always just keep adding a nodal line. One nodal line raises the energy, two nodal lines, nodal planes really, raise the energy even more. And so if we put one node in, we will flip the phases to opposite for one side. And what that will do is raise the energy of our next molecular orbital, and as we've drawn it, it would look like this. We want to raise the energy again. Well, we put in two nodal lines. The only way to do that is in this configuration. And so this would look like two in the middle in phase, and then the ones on the outside out of phase with those in the middle. So if we put that on our molecular orbital sketch here, two lobes, then bigger lobes in the middle, lobes on the outside, still seeing those nodal lines as we merge our orbitals. And then finally, we can put three nodal planes into our compound, and then everything will go out of phase. And so what do we really have? We have all four of our p orbitals back, except they're all out of phase with one another. If we're labeling these for molecular orbital diagram, our first orbital we'll call psi 1, our second psi 2, third psi 3, and our highest energy we'll call psi 4. Butadiene has 4 pi electrons, so we'll put in 1, 2, 3, and 4 for 2 pi bonding MOs. The antibonding orbitals are left unoccupied.